Okay, now, so after we have already solved for conversion from degree to radian, then radian to degree, we'll now start solving right triangles. So since ito naman talaga yung first lesson natin, or the first major branch ng plane trigonometry. So there are things to remember in solving right triangles. So first and foremost, the sum of angle measurements within a triangle is equal to 180 degrees. So, kahit anong klaseng triangle to, whether it's a right triangle or an oblique triangle, the sum of the internal angles, yung angle na nasa loob, okay, ng triangle is equal to 180 degrees. So, in this case, sa triangle na to, theta plus the right angle plus beta equals 180 degrees. So theta plus yung right angle na 90 degrees plus yung beta, the total will be equal to 180 degrees. Okay, that is the first thing to remember when solving right triangles. Second is the hypotenuse. Okay, so the hypotenuse is the longest side. Basically, the longest side of the right triangle. So in this case, yung hypotenuse natin is this one. Yung pinakamahaba na side ng ating triangle. Okay? The next one is the adjacent side with respect to the angle. Isa naman is we call the opposite side with respect to the angle. Pag sinabi namang opposite, kung adjacent is katabi, yung opposite naman is, okay, atbang. Okay? Opposite, ano ba yung katapat. Okay? Katapat na side. Again, with respect to the angle. Now, very important tong term binanggit dito, with respect to the angle. Okay? Adjacent side with respect to the angle, opposite side with respect to the angle. For example, we consider this angle theta. Okay? So, alam na natin that this is the hypotenuse. So, yung hindi na lang natin alam, is T adjacent to theta or is it opposite? Is M adjacent to theta or is it opposite? So in this case, since if we consider angle theta, okay, yung katapat niya na side, atbang niya na side is itong side na M. Okay? Atbang. Well, yung katabi niya na side, since dalawa lang to na side, it's either ito or ito. But since ito, we already determined this one to be the hypotenuse of our triangle. So, walang ibang adjacent side, kundi ito lang. Okay? So, this T. Okay? T is the adjacent side with respect to angle theta. And M is the opposite side with respect to angle theta. But if we consider beta, okay, ito naman, itong angle na to, yung adjacent side ng beta, yung katabi niya, so, dalawa lang, this one na side or this one. Now, since this one is already the hypotenuse, so wala nang pag-asa yan na maging adjacent. So, automatic, itong M will be our adjacent side. Katabi na side ni angle beta. Yung opposite side naman ng angle beta will be itong side T. Katapat. Okay? So, yan. And lastly, nothing to remember, the Pythagorean theorem. Okay? It is used to find a missing side of a right triangle when given two sides. Okay? So kung pinahanap sa iyo yung isang side, given may value itong T at saka M, masasolve natin to. Given ka ng hypotenuse at itong M, masasolve natin yung T. So basically, yun yung ibig sabihin ng meaning nito. So ano ba yung Pythagorean theorem? So, it states that the sum of the squares of the two legs of a right triangle is equal to the square of the longest side. So, in equation form, it will look like this. So, kung ito yung triangle natin, in consideration, okay, the formula will be in the form T squared plus M squared is equal to S squared. Now, paano naging ganyan? Okay. Base dito sa binanggit kanina na Pythagorean theorem, sabi niya, the sum of the squares of the two legs of a right triangle So, yung two legs na binabanggit niya dito is this M at saka itong T. Since this one is not a leg, this is the hypotenuse or the longer side. Okay? The sum of the squares of the two legs, T and M, is equal to the square of the longest side. So the square of the longer side, which is S. So, kaya ganito yung nangyari sa formula for Pythagorean theorem. So those are basically the four things or the five things that we need to remember. So again, balikan natin. Okay, the sum ng angles within a triangle, right triangle is 180 degrees. The hypotenuse is the longer side. The adjacent side is yung katabi. Opposite side is atbang, okay, or katapat na side. Okay, again, very important kung anong angle yung pinagbabasehan natin. Okay, and then lastly, yung ating Pythagorean theorem. Okay, now there are six trigonometric functions of angles. Okay, so ito yun. Kalista dito. Sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, cotangent. Now, these are its yung mga abbreviations. Yan. Ito yung makikita natin sa calculator. Sin, cos, tan, cosecant, secant, cot. Okay? So, sine theta, cosine theta, tangent theta, cosecant theta, secant theta, and cotangent theta. Now, paano ba natin makukuha yung values nito? Okay, so how will we solve or find the values of the six trigonometric functions that were mentioned a while ago? Okay, so given this triangle, so we have this given angle theta, the right angle, then these sides S, E, and M, where S is our hypotenuse. Okay, so if we will solve for sine theta, okay, sine theta is just equal to the opposite side with respect to the given angle over the hypotenuse. So in this case, our given angle is theta. Okay? So the opposite side to angle theta, yung atbang or katapat na side ni angle theta, is this side T divided by the hypotenuse. That is why it is equal to side T divided by side S. Okay, nasundan? Now, for cosine theta, okay, cosine theta with respect to this triangle is equal to the adjacent side with respect to angle theta divided by the hypotenuse. So, theta is here. So, yung katabi niya na side, di pwede yung S kasi ito yung hypotenuse, is the side M. Okay, so ito yung adjacent side divided by the hypotenuse. So that is why it resulted to the side M divided by side S. Now, for tangent theta, okay, it is equal to the opposite side with respect to angle theta divided by the adjacent side. Again, with respect to angle theta. So it is opposite side T divided by adjacent side M. Okay? Kaya it is T divided by M. So, madalas nating maririnig ito, especially pag trigonometry. Okay? Ito yung may mnemonic, or para mas madali natin maalala, na SOHCAHTOA. Okay? So, meaning S sine opposite over hypotenuse. So, S O H K C A H, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, then TOA, tangent, T O A, okay, opposite over adjacent. Now, what about the remaining three trigonometric functions? Okay, the cosecant, okay, secant, and the cotangent. Now, for cosecant, It is just the hypotenuse over the opposite side. Okay? For a second, it is just hypotenuse over adjacent. For cotangent, adjacent over opposite. Now, kung mapapansin ninyo, okay, kung titingnan nyo yung nasa kaliwa, okay, this is the sine theta. O, dito, opposite over hypotenuse. Dito naman, hypotenuse over opposite. Kung dito, T over S. Dito, S over T. So, parang in-interchange lang natin. Ang tawag dito is, we just took the reciprocal of the value of the sine of the angle. Okay? Kung dito, T over S, pag kunin natin yung cosecant, theta, it is just S over T. Pag kunin naman natin yung second, okay, it is just the reciprocal of the cosine theta. Kung M over S yung cosine theta, yung second theta natin will be S divided by M. Okay? Kung kunin naman natin yung cotangent, kung tangent theta natin is T over M, mangyari sa cotangent theta natin will be M over T. At kung dito, it's SOHCAHTOA, ito naman, CHOHCAHTOA. Okay? Cosecant is hypotenuse over opposite. Second is hypotenuse over adjacent. And cotangent is adjacent over opposite. Okay? So, yan. So, that's how we get the trigonometric function values. Now, values since pwede kasi na yung S, M, at saka T may value. Okay? So, pag may value yan, substitute lang natin dito. Dito. Okay? Okay, so, here we have a challenge. So, sabi ito, you try. Determine the 6 trigonometric function values of angle beta and compare with the results for angle theta. So, this one, itong nasolve natin dito is actually the 6 trigonometric functions of angle theta. Okay? Now, for this challenge, okay, what if meron tayong this angle? We call this angle beta. Okay? Ano daw yung 6 trigonometric functions ng angle na to? Okay? And then you compare it with the results for the 6 trigonometric functions of angle theta. Okay? So you do that. Okay? Tingnan natin kung makukuha ninyo yung relationship between the two. Okay? Now, we have a sample problem here involving a right triangle. So, sabi dito, given that the right triangle below, this one, solve for the value of h, the 6 trigonometric function values of angle theta, and also the value of theta and beta. Now, ito daw, hanapin daw natin yung value ng side h, the 6 trigonometric function values of angle theta, nado yung 6 trigonometric function values nito, the value, anong value din ng theta, and the value of beta. So, how do we solve this? Okay? First and foremost, so for solving the value of h, okay, we will be using yung binanggit natin kanina na thing to remember. We'll use the Pythagorean theorem, okay? To solve for the value of h. So, nabanggit natin kanina na pag given ka ng dalawang side, okay, in this case, 12 at saka 5, may missing na side, isa. Pwede natin gamitin yung Pythagorean theorem kapag yung given na triangle ay right triangle. Okay? So, in this case, the square of the two legs, 5 and 12. So, 5 squared plus 12 squared is equal to the square of the longest side, which is h, yung hinahanap natin. So, 5 squared plus 12 squared, that will be 25. Since 5 squared is 5 times 5, 12 squared is 12 times 12, so 144. So, 25 plus 144 is 169. Equal to h squared, we take the square root of both sides, take the square root of 169, take the square root of h squared, okay? So, we'll have 13 units is equal to each. Okay? So we now solve the value of this side, determine the value of this side to be 13 units. Now, we can directly check our answer. Okay? We said that h is the longest side. Kung compare natin yung value, since this is 13, makita natin that 13 is actually greater than the given sides, which are 5 and 12. Okay? So, by that, masasabi natin na kahit na, okay, hindi pa natin na-check, okay, this 13 is malamang ito talaga yung answer since it is greater than the two given sides. Okay? Next, we solve for the six trigonometric functions of theta. Now, this is theta. So, ano doon yung six trigonometric functions? So, una, gamitan natin ng Sokotowa. Okay? So, for the sine theta, opposite over hypotenuse. Opposite ng theta na side is 5 over hypotenuse na 13. Okay? Yung cosine theta, ka, adjacent over hypotenuse. Adjacent side ng angle theta, yung katabi niya na side, is 12 over 13. Okay? Yung tangent naman ng angle theta is TOA, opposite over adjacent. So, kung ito yung angle theta, opposite, katapat niya is 5, adjacent niya is 12. Okay? So, 5 over 12. Now, taking the reciprocal of all these three trigonometric functions, so yung cosecant theta, baliktarin lang natin, 13 over 5. Yung second theta, baliktarin lang natin yung cosine, so we have 13 over 12. And then yung cotangent theta, baliktarin lang natin yung tangent, it will be 12 over 5. You just take the reciprocal. Or, chosha kao. Okay? So, these are the six trigonometric functions of angle theta. Okay? Now, what if we want to determine the value of angle theta? Ano ba yung, ilang degrees ba to? Itong angle na to? So, to find that, we just get one trigonometric function. Okay? For example, we take the value of sine theta, which is equal to kanina 5 over 13. Now, to solve for the value of theta, we take the arc sine of both sides of the equation, or we take the inverse trigonometric function. Kung sine yan, arc sine yung kanyang inverse trigonometric function. So, how do we do that? So, we take the arc sine of sine theta, we take the arc sine of 5 over 13. Kung ano yung ginawa mo dito sa kaliwa, gawin mo din sa kanan to preserve the equality. Okay? So, in this case, pag kinuha natin yung arc sine ng sine, this will just be cancelled out, matitira yung angle na theta. And if we, kung gamitin natin yung calculator, okay, sa ibabaw ng sine button sa calculator, okay, kung hawak ninyo yung calculator nyo ngayon, tingnan ninyo, sa ibabaw ng sine na button, may makikita kayo dyan na naka-yellow, okay, the symbol arc sine. Okay? So, meaning ng naka-yellow is ipipress nyo pa yung shift ng calculator, then press the sine button para lumabas ito sa inyong calculator. Okay, so, arc sine, then open parenthesis, 5 divided by 13, lalabas yung sagot na theta is equal to 22.62 degrees. Okay? So, ito palang angle na to is 22.62 degrees. How about angle beta? Ano yung value ng angle beta? Okay? Now, by the way, before we proceed to solving beta, okay, you can also try, okay? Kanina, ginamit natin arc sine. Okay? But what if gamitin mo yung value ng cosine theta? Okay? But instead of using arc sine, gagamitin mo arc cosine or this, okay, symbol. So again, kung ang arc sine nasa ibabaw ng sine button ng calculator, ito naman nasa ibabaw to ng cosine button ng calculator. Okay? Yung tangent theta naman, kung gagamitin mo to, instead of using arc sine, gamitin mo arc tangent. Okay? And then proceed. Tingnan natin kung makukuha mo pa rin ba yung same result na theta is 22.62 degrees. Okay? Now, since nasolve na natin yung 22.62 degrees, okay, if we add all the angles in a triangle, sabi natin kanina sa thing to remember, the sum is 180. Pag in-add natin itong theta, itong 90 degree angle, at itong beta, equals sa 180. So, since nakuha na natin yung theta, 22.62, beta, hindi pa natin alam, the 90 degrees, equals 180. Kung ilipat natin to sa kabila, magiging negative. Ito naman, pag ilipat sa kabila, magiging negative, maiiwan yung beta. Okay? At pag isolve mo to, na 180 minus 22.62 minus 90, lalabas yung sagot that beta is 67.38 degrees. Okay? Now, there's another challenge here. Here's another way to solve for the value of beta. So, merong ibang paraan para masolve yung beta. Based on our previous discussions na kung ano yan, can you find this other way? Okay? Meron ka bang naiisip na paraan? Paano mo makuha yung 67.38 na hindi gagamitin itong pamamaraan na ito? Okay? So again, you base it on the previous discussions. Okay? Now, the summary of answers. So yung H, nakuha natin kanina, 13 units through Pythagorean theorem. Yung 6 trigonometric functions, nakuha natin gamit yung Sokatoa at saka Chow-Shakao. Then yung theta, nakuha natin gamit yung inverse trigonometric function, whether it's arc cosine, arc sine, arc tangent. At yung beta, which is equal to 67.38 degrees. Okay? So, if you have questions relating to this video, you may write it on the comments below. Okay? If wala naman, okay, I have prepared an assignment related to this lesson, okay, that I will be posting on our Google Classroom. So, you may also check that out. It is worth 20 points, okay, and it is an application of the things that we have discussed here in this slides, okay. So, meaning kung hindi nyo naintindihan or hindi nyo naintindihan itong diniscuss natin dito, mahirapan din kayo dun sa ating ginawang assignment. But if you understood the topics that we have discussed here, hindi kayo mahirapan when answering that particular assignment. So, pwede din kayong mag-collaborate with your classmates in answering, okay, through social media. Kasi nga, hindi tayo pwedeng magkita-kita ngayon since quarantine, okay? So, with that, I leave you with this first lesson and I'll be giving additional materials for you to solve and for you to apply the lessons that you have learned in this particular discussion. Okay? So, see you on the next lecture video.